see, I saw a couple of you guys just staying on your feet, so there was a lot of distance from your chest to his back. When we snap him down, our chest is coming to his back immediately. All right, we want there to be in his face. So as I snap, my chest is falling down on top of it. No space. And then I circle behind. Okay? So, just a review of what we went over this session. Number one, good stance. If you want to have a good stance, you're going to have to work on it and practice through drilling, going live, thinking about it. Anytime there's a fresh start, we touch our fingertips to the mat, our knees are bent, heads up, putting pressure into somebody. We want the advantage. We don't want to be in the center of the circle. We want to have them facing the outside of the mat, our butt facing the center, driving into our opponent. Thumb block. Guys, remember thumb block. That's important. Thumb block is good for defense and good for offense. Okay, so remember it. Then when we snap, we got a bunch of different setups when we go behind down. A bunch of different ways to take people down. We drop them forward, we snap them to our knee. First one, just normal go behind. Put his elbow to the mat. Circle behind. Second one, put his elbow to the mat. Try to circle three faces. We change directions. Other one, guys, in the quad pod. Ankle pick, throw his head away, come up to our feet. Next one is we get the underhook, drive him up to his feet, push his head to the outside, it pops out, we lower our level, high crotch, and then finally his head pops out, we fake, that leg goes back, snap back down. Behind him. So it's a good series. Drill it, spar, see what your partner does, see the way that he reacts. People react different ways, but if you kind of stick within the guidelines of the general technique, then make it your own. All the shots that I do, my two best shots I would say are ankle pick and the low single, and I get a decent amount of go behinds. But ankle pick and low single especially, I just made the tags my own. I watch film of people. I ask my coaches how to help me. But for the most part, I was coaching myself. Held myself accountable to learn the technique, to do it the right way. And that's why I think I'm good at those moves now and I can hit them on people because I made the technique my own. I know the way that it feels. I know the way that I want my opponent to feel. I know the way that he's going to react when I do the setups, so I've done them a lot. That's the same stuff that you guys should be doing when you're drilling. All right, so good job. Easy. Yeah. That's the end of this session, and I think there's an announcement. So,
you got this, you're going to
Yeah, okay, guys.